On mission. Okay, we move.
Hello everyone. Today I'm going to talk about the Locke's principle of exchange in forensic science. Welcome to my channel Onesimus Manjala. If you are new here, make sure you subscribe to this channel and also hit the notification bell and like our videos because it really helps a lot. So the Locke's principle of exchange in forensic science holds that the perpetrator of a crime will bring something new in the crime scene and also leave with something else from the crime scene. So both whatever he was able to bring to the crime scene and what he left with can be used as forensic evidence. So these ones we talk about wherever he's going to step, whatever he touches when committing this particular crime, and even we also look at whatever maybe he was able to break while at this crime scene, they are going to serve as silent witness against him. So when you talk about this principle of exchange, we are not only talking about the fingerprints in terms of whatever he was able to touch and also the footprints like where he steps, but also the fibers like the fiber from the cloth here that was left at the crime scene. And maybe the investigators are going to compare with maybe the shirt that is suspected to have been used at this particular crime. We also maybe look at the glass was able to break it if it's a crime of a house breaking, or maybe the tools of crime that was left at the crime scene, or maybe that contact that was able to occur between that maybe the tool of crime in terms of maybe it's a weapon, it's a murder weapon. We are going to compare this versus maybe what you're able to capture from the suspect. So the investigators are going to piece together all this information, and the information left behind we term as the trace evidence. So trace evidence basically is just these are the remains that were left behind by the these are perpetrator or maybe the criminals. So we all say that the physical evidence cannot lie. If this is the fingerprint that were left for the crime scene, and we have done what we call a forensic analysis and compare the fingerprints with yours and they are matching, there is no way you're going to disapprove of this particular theory. And even the footprints in terms of maybe the shoe that you are wearing, if we compare with the ones that we're able to maybe to collect from the crime scene, it's matching. So there's no way you're going to say that this physical evidence is going to be maybe lying against you. So the investigators normally do this job like maybe taking the video of or the photograph of what they call the crime scene. We take it in a three dimension, maybe before you collect the evidence and after you finish collecting this particular evidence. Then most of these are evidence like the blood specimen collected from the crime scene are normally taken for what we call a forensic analysis. Then the results are out to be able to match maybe with the suspect they are having. So thank you so much for this short video.